members of the committee. If I had my way,
we'd invite everybody.
It's like a religious service. We're all trying to sit as far away as we can. We fear you.
Good morning. This is the Senate Higher Education Committee first meeting. My name is Toby Stavisky, and I'm privileged to chair the committee. Today is Monday, January 14th. And first, I'd like to welcome everybody back to Albany and welcome our new members. And going around the room, we have Senator Breslin, Senator Seward, Senator Granada, Senator Roback, Senator Amador, Senator Serrano. Senator Hoylman is not a member of the committee, but he will be addressing us in a moment. And Senator May, and Senator Gloren, and Senator Jackson. And to my left is the Legislative Committee Director, Jan Dorman, who will be calling the memos, etc. Senator LaValle is the ranking member on the committee, and he has left his voting sheet. He has not arrived in Albany yet. A quorum is present, and if nobody wishes to make any opening statements, we will go directly to the agenda. There is only one bill, print number, bill number 1046 by Senator Hoylman. Will the Legislative Director read the title?
The only bill on today's agenda is Senate Bill 1046 by Senator Hoylman. This bill provides that if a mental health professional licensed, registered or certified by the State Education Department engages in sexual orientation change efforts on any patient under the age of 18, that professional should be subject to penalties relating to professional misconduct under the education law. This bill was reported out of this committee last year, and this bill is reported to go to the Rules Committee this year.
Thank you. Before we come to the roll call, in May 15th of 2014, Senator Hoylman held a roundtable discussion, a public forum, entitled Protecting LGBT Youth from Conversion Therapy in New York State. And he has been a persistent and compassionate advocate for the ban on conversion therapy, and I'm delighted to ask him to address the committee.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and it's quite an honor to be here. It's an honor because our leader not just supports this legislation to ban the barbaric practice of so-called conversion therapy, but she's also put it so high on the Senate's agenda, literally the first day, and that is such a testament to her and to Senator Mike Gianaris, who is the prime co-sponsor of this legislation. The Secretary described what the bill does. We are proposing to follow 14 other states plus Washington, D.C., and no longer permitting licensed state mental health professionals from trying to convert LGBTQ kids into something they are not. And we know the practice persists in the state of New York, notwithstanding Governor Cuomo's executive actions. I believe that it is tantamount to child abuse to try to change a kid's sexual orientation. And more importantly, we have to consider the message that we're sending today to LGBTQ kids across the state of New York, that we have your back and you are perfect just the way you are.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Hoylman. Are there any questions or comments? Senator Jackson.
Madam Chair, I rise in order to speak in favor of this, and I support wholeheartedly, as described by my colleague Brad, and I know Brad for several years as a member of the City Council of New York, and I not only know him, but I know his children and his husband, and I appreciate him and what he's doing. And I've read the summary as to how many members of the state senate have signed on. And as you know, there are 39 state senators that have signed on to this bill, which basically says wholeheartedly that the New York State Senate, at least the Democrats, by the way, supports this particular action. So I support it wholeheartedly. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Senator Jackson. Are there any other comments?
Madam Chair. Question. Is if a child wants to, or parent of the child wants to have some type of therapy that is done by a licensed professional, and they consent to it, would this bar that so that there would be no option whatsoever for the type of therapy or treatment?
There would be no bar on discussing with a child his or her sexual identity or gender identity or expression. This has no impact on adults. This is only for children under 18 years old.
So if a 17-year-old wanted to go through therapy or talk with their the therapist, then, and the therapist is licensed and a professional in this method of therapy, they would no longer be able to prescribe that.
That's correct. You could no longer, as a state licensed therapist, attempt a sexual orientation change effort on your patient if he or she is a minor. If he's an adult, that's a different story, and we still allow that under the bill. Adults could be subject to this, but quite frankly, that may go to the issue of consumer fraud, which may be an issue for another day, given that there are no examples of sexual orientation change efforts actually succeeding. That's why, Senator, it's such a pernicious practice, because not only does it not work, but the message that it sends to the individual is so destructive. And the people who are being ripped off are the parents who falsely believe that because the state of New York has licensed this individual, this therapist knows what they're talking about, when the scores of medical and mental health professional organizations have all determined that it is a discredited practice.
No further questions.
Are there any other questions? Well, I thank Senator Parlman for his tenacity and since there are no more questions, would somebody like to move the bill? Moved by Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Boren. All in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Senator Amador and Senator LaValle opposed. Are there any without recommendation? Aye, without recommendation. Senator Seward and Senator Robach. The bill is referred to the Rules Committee. And seeing no other individuals wishing to speak, the Committee on Higher Education is adjourned.